Shot 123.
Was it scary again? Yeah.
Hey, why don't you go back inside, man? I'm just trying to bottle my breaths.
Hey.
Hold on.
Hey, why don't you go back inside, man? I'm just trying to bottle my breaths.
Hey.
Hey. Hey, why don't you go back inside, man? I'm just trying to bottle my breaths.
Hey.
Casey Frey, the most distinct voice of all time. That's me when I was a kid outside playing with imaginary friends, and my mom would peek her head throughout like the back screen door and be like, "Hey, Benny, it's time to do homework." And I'd be like,
"Hey, why don't you go back inside, man? I'm just trying to bottle my breaths."
And then she'd be like, she'd change her voice like all moms do and be like,
"Hey."
So, yeah. All right, let's let this intro play. Okay, kind of scary. Can somebody send me a beat so I don't have to do that every single time? Honestly, that takes me like 10 minutes to find one that's good. But if you guys like the intros the way they are, then we're going to keep doing it. What's up, man? Shot 123. The last shot was hype. I got a lot of good feedback. People really liked it, so we're going to keep doing. I'm going to keep putting out questions like every week, and then you guys can give me answers, and we'll break it down on the pod. It'll be like a whole segment. So if you have a question or something you want me to ask, or if you have a good topic or something that pisses you off or just anything like that, let me know, and I'll put it out there, and we can talk. Baby, let's talk. All right, so remember to follow on Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, Cameo, all at Benedict Polizzi. Hit me up. Remember to subscribe to the podcast. Tell your friends, fam, subscribe, rate, review. You know, it helps. It does, for real. Because your boy's not really getting paid. He's just doing this for the love of the game. He's just doing this for the love of the family. We stay together. FAM, I love you. Okay, this week we've got mispronunciations that you can't stand. It sounded like I was going to say like Miss and then a last name. Hello, I'm mispronunciation. And she just says everything wrong. Hello, I'm mispronunciation. Would you like some potatoes? Or tomatoes? Why did it turn into a guy? I don't know, but that's going to be a new character. No, but a lot of people hit me up with their most annoying mispronunciations.
Yes!
And that's my favorite shit of all time. I don't know if you can tell or not, but I like it. And then we got some stuff. We got some news we'll talk about, and we'll just ride it out. Normal show. With me in the driver's seat, so you're fucked. First, we got to talk about what's going on in the world. What happened? Odell Beckham Jr. likes getting shit on? Of course I'm going to talk about this. The podcast that's only about shitting. But yeah, okay, so let's break this down real quick. Where's that interview? Okay, here we go. This is from the No Jumper podcast, where they unfold the whole Odell shit thing.
Yeah. Are they ready for this? He said, yeah.
Yeah, go, baby. What?
You can't. You got Odell Beckham.
You can keep it. Oh!
So I guess they're talking about like who'd you shit on?
You got.
She was like, okay.
You can keep it.
Bombs. Okay, I will tell y'all the story.
Oh, allegedly. We're avoiding lawsuits here.
Yeah, allegedly. Yes, he loves to be shitted on.
The way she said that was so depressing, though. He loves to be shitted on.
Yes, he loves to be shitted on. Okay, he wanted me to come on a plane.
What?
And he was like, make sure you don't have any underwear. Don't take a shower for 24 hours. I'm like, damn, what the fuck you on? But he was like, take a picture. This is how I got flown out. He was like, take a picture of me. You shitting. So I was like, all right, fuck. I can do that. So I took a whole video, bitch. What you want?
Take a video?
Me shitting. So I sent it to him. I got, like, the next maybe 2 hours I was in Houston.
Was it like a selfie video? How did you do this?
I was just
need
that.
I need less than
shitting. Just like I
really think this is gonna change everything in the like it was feet, now it's shit. It's just happening.
Sexy as possible.
Of course. I'm gonna do that.
I feel like anything things. You do is
hold on.
I made it sexy as possible.
Of course.
I made it sexy as possible.
Of course.
Dude, how do you make
shitting?
Imagine shitting and make and being like cute about it.
Made it sexy as possible.
Of course.
Only a girl can pull that off. Like girl going to the bathroom. Whatever. Guy going to the bathroom. No! Like what she do? Was she wearing like pink slippers?
The exclusive on No Jumper, baby.
No Jumper.
How to bag Del Beckham.
Like, how do you bring that up? If you're in like a normal, like non-celebrity relationship, like how do you bring that up to your girlfriend? Like, hey. She's like, what do you want? What do you want me to do to you? And you're like, just normal, do you know? Normal stuff. She's like, you sure I want to get crazy tonight? And you're like, me too, obviously. I mean, we always, you know, I'm always down to get freaky. And she's like, just tell me what you want me to do to you. Well, if you want to get crazy, have you eaten like some, can you eat a couple of these Slim Jims here? Why are they right there on our nightstand? Did you have something in mind? No. Just eat some of these Slim Jims and why is there a big pot of coffee on our nightstand too? Oh, no reason. I was thinking like maybe like, well, during this, just tell me what you want. Could you shit on all over me? What if she was like, absolutely. Oh, what did you say? She looks back and he's gone. Dude, you really got to be in love to be like, just shit on me. How relieving would it be to be a girl like around Odell Beckham Jr. though? Like, it's like with it, when you're hooking up with any guy, it's probably like number one for a girl to be like, okay, just like be cool. Don't worry about it. Be yourself. And just don't fart. But with Odell Beckham Jr., it's like, be cool, you know, just be yourself and fart as much as possible. What a relief. Just all over, hey, rings the doorbell, ding, dong. He's like, come on in. You're like, what's going on? He's like, hi, how you doing? Can't even look you in the face. What a kink, man. Every time a girl leaves Odell Beckham Jr.'s house, right when they walk out the door.
If you got at least one person in your life you want to shit on, put your nose in the air right now.
Right when they walk out the door. All right, Odell, it was fun. He's like, ha, yeah, like wiping shit off of his mouth. No, it's just on some weird part of him that like doesn't make any sense. Just like on the back of his like, it's on the back of his like, it's on his like tricep. He's like, and she's like, I'll see you later. Shuts the door behind her. She's walking down the driveway. That's still her ass. Still like making, still fucking making noises. Yeah, that's it.
Shit it on him. And I just shit it on him. Shit it, put your number twos in the air if you shit it on him.
Walking down the driveway, two peace signs up. The neighbors are like, okay, see you later. Some guy cutting his grass. Odell's looking out the window, like waving, like the prettiest bitch. Odell's double waving at the window like your grandparents when you're leaving their house for Easter. He's like, bye. Like so happy. And you're just walking down the driveway. The girl's walking down the driveway like.
Shit it on him.
Still farting. This noise. Odell Beckham Jr. is my son.
And I'ma go and get some pips for him.
I'ma go and get some Slim Jims for him. And eat them on the way home with a venti iced Americano and maybe a couple of hard boiled eggs. And then I'm gonna jump some rope. Then I'm gonna do double dutch on that ass, what? And it's all gonna get mixed up. And when OBJ asks me what's up, I'm going to open up my butt and be like, and I'm going to be like, yo, go Browns. Hot, 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 hot. Oh, my God.
Shitting on him. Man, I just shitted on him.
Put your number twos in the air if it kind of smells like the last thing that you were around. Dude, every time I do that, it smells like the last thing I was around. Like, if I'm around your dog, my shit will smell exactly like your dog. That's like my mutant power. Dude, this podcast. I swear to God. They're like, the X-Men have arrived. This one has claws. This one can control the weather. This one can read your mind. And this one's shit smells like whatever he was around last. And they're like, all right, we'll take him. Wow. How the Browns, like, keep him happy now. How funny that he plays for the Browns. Like, damn. I love that he owned up to it, too. He, like, posted something on Instagram. And he's like, can't knock my pivot. I don't care what kind of shit's thrown my way. Like, dude, just, you don't have to be, like, inspirational with it. Whatever, though. Yeah, the Browns training staff, though. Odell, what do you need? What do you need? What do you need to, what do you need from us to, you know, play your heart out this Sunday? He's like, new pair of gloves, or new gloves, got it. That trail mix I like that at halftime. They're like, oh, okay, yeah, no problem. And can you shit on my face? We can do that for you. What was that last thing he said? I don't know, I couldn't hear him. Hey, Michelle, what was that last thing he said? He wants, at halftime when he's feeling like he needs to recharge, he wants someone on the training staff to shit in his mouth. That's like on the checkboard. That's like on their like calendar. Mike, this week you got water for all the players. You got the fog machines. Get those going. And you got you're shitting on Odell this week. So be ready for that too. Yep. Whatever you got to do, man, to get ready for that. Drink your coffee. Yep. Eat your dairy. I know dairy makes you go crazy, so eat that Yoplait, big guy. Get out of here. All right. What else? After that, we're just casually. What else?
Let me shake it off. I just.
did it on him. All right, I got to go to work, but when we get back, we're doing most annoying mispronunciations. All right, BRB. Okay, here we go. I'm back. Mispronunciations you can't stand. Here we go. Cat Lady Katie. My boyfriend doesn't mispronounce words necessarily, but he gets them confused, like, maybe you should have better expirations instead of aspirations. Ah! How do you love him? I'm dead serious. He also thought jukebox was called a juice box. I can't like anyone that I can't do that. How do you like someone that thinks that? Like, can you imagine what else they think? If they think jukebox, even though why is it called that? I get that. Is juice box. Like, that's a deal breaker. All right. That was pretty good. When people say both, it makes me want to die. There's no L in the word both. Ew. God damn it. I just said that like that. I can't believe I just did that. But what is that? Spell it. Do you like Cheerios or Apple Jacks? Both. Why? That last one was from Patty Mayo, both. Ew. This one's from Grace Hurt. One of my best friends pronounces Elon Musk's first name Ellen, and he's also one of those people that calls pillows pillows. Who are you? This has to be so Indiana, but Ellen Rack said, Worsher? I can't even say this shit. And instead of toilet, turlet. Who's doing this? Seriously, what culture? All right, Kitty Maxwell. So many, that's so funny that the girls that DM me all have cats in their name. What's that say about me? Kitty Maxwell, my mom says house with a W, like house. House. That sucks. Draws it out psychotically, too. Sarah and I call each other to calm down whenever she does it because it makes us that angry. I totally get that. You literally, something, oh my God, dude. Every time my dad says something, I really have to go outside and like, I have to do yoga for like 4 hours after I talk to my dad for like 2 minutes. I'm like, inner peace. You're gonna be fine. This is all gonna be okay. Yeah. Just it's, we've got plenty of those at the house. Oh! All right, here's another one. Laura Stinkin. All right, your last name is something I can't stand. My mom says Qdoba as Quadoba. Oh, no, dude. Why can't they change? Hey, you want to go? Hey, yeah. I'm feeling Mexican, too. Chips and salsa? I know, the perfect place. Quadoba. No! This is just, sorry if you hate this segment, but this is going to be me screaming the whole time. Okay, K Pirtle 15. Instead of milk, melk. It's like an alt. That was like my origin story of mispronunciations. Instead of pillow, pillow. Hate that so much. Yeah, we can't. I mean, why? Why? Just why? Ask them why. If someone says something like, I can't do it. That's like the greatest fear of mine. Because I asked my dad so many times growing up. My dad would say something weird growing up, and I'd be like, why you say it like that? And he'd like scream at me. I'd be like, oh. If someone says pillow, ask him why. I just want to know. All right, here we go. Olivia Grace does hair. My mom says, oh, no. Chipotle instead of Chipotle. Yeah, that's pretty like standard among parents. Why can't parents talk? I think it's funny, like when you're a kid, your parents teach you how to talk. And when you're grown up, you got to teach your parents how to talk again. Ew, God, this is the grossest thing of all time. Ewa Fricks. My mom calls it a virginia. Instead of a vagina. That's like the devil. Your mom's Satan. Allie Pierce. This is going to be good. Not a mispronunciation, but when people excessively say, you know what I mean. Ew, yeah. That's like me every minute. You know what I mean? Oh, I do that too much. She probably hates me. Fontaine de Maine. Several coworkers say feet print instead of footprints. Makes me wonder if I'm even wrong, even though okay, I'm not. Feet print. Ugh, dude. Do you guys get the chills with this shit? All right, Jenna Kennard. Andrew says naked instead of naked. No, he doesn't. No. That's like from a movie. Jenna, can you record him saying that, please, and send it to me so I can peacefully die? All right, B... Key Pin Beesh. What kind of fucking name is that? Barnard. Instead of Bernard, Barnard. You can't say something's annoying after your name's B Key Pin Beesh. What is that? Would you like to try the beekeeping beach? Okay. Cheyenne Broughton. We're moving through these. My ex used to add letters to words, so he would say, yeah, your ex, for sure. Good job. My ex used to add letters to words, so he would say breakfast, and it sounded like breakfast, frist. Dude, I would seriously... Or Indianapolis would be Indianapolis. That is... I can't talk about it anymore. I'm done. All right. Kaylee Pittman. My dad says Umber instead of Uber. Dude, my dad used to say Uber. And I was like, just why? He also can't figure out that Hudson's grandma is Mimi because he calls her Maymay. That was the weirdest thing of all time when you're growing up and you're like some kid in your fifth grade class was like, yeah, we went to my mama's house. And you're like, what the fuck? Papa was the one that just slit me open.
Papa!
It's like your grandpa sounds like a diaper. Pampa, that's... Now here's a... Alright, here's a sex story I didn't read. We're tossing these in here too now. This is from Joe Burns. Weirdest sex story, Joe Burns. One time I was hooking up with this girl and her little brother comes down and sees us kissing and goes, Mom, Casey and her friend are having sex in the basement. And the kid had no idea what sex was and we got screamed at by her mom. Ah, it sucks. When a girl's mom, like when you like a girl and her mom hates you, there's no going back. Like that first, like if your girlfriend's mom hates you, she hates you forever. Like you could like, if you, whatever you did, like, and then you buy them like jet skis, like they're still like, yeah, fuck that guy. They're like on them. They're like, fuck that guy. Joe Burns again for worst mispronunciation. My girlfriend says Friday instead of Friday, and it's come to the point where I can't even see her on Fridays. What's up? Yep. Tomorrow, Thursday, I'm not really doing anything, but Friday? Oh. Also, girl in the last pod who didn't know where guys peed. Yeah, you're right. We pee out of our belly buttons. That was crazy. She didn't know that. That's funny. Okay. This is from Colin.and. Supposedly. He says supposedly. Such a bitch. That is pretty funny. Supposedly. Ew. Yeah, next time somebody pronounces something wrong, just go, you're a bitch. See what they do. You can't talk. You're a bitch. Yeah, I'm really sick, and I just want to lay down on one of these pillows. Hey, you're a bitch. What? My ex used to say exorb instead of absorb. Where are you finding these people? These people are clones of actual people that aren't 100% developed yet. Okay, this is from Indigenous Tierney. Pacifically instead of specifically. Honestly, let's narrow this down. I'm trying to be as Pacific as possible. I'm trying to be as oceanic as possible. I'm trying to be as Atlantic as possible. I'm trying to sail the seven seas as much as possible this summer. I can't believe some of this shit's real. Okay. The voice of reason. All right, bro. We'll see. He goes, leisure. It's meant to be leisure, but hearing is pronounced like leisure. Hurts my ear holes. You're probably right because that's just where you're from or something, but you said ear holes at the end. And for that, bye. That's it. I can't take it anymore. There's literally 40 more, but I can't do this anymore. Let's finish up weird sex stories from last week. I think there's a couple more. Here we go. Nicholas Brusa Corum. Girl picks me up in college from her college an hour away. Then holds me kidnapped at her place for 72 hours until she decides she's going to drive me home. Phone died 3 hours in, and she didn't have an iPhone charger. Yeah, it's pretty terrifying. What would I do there? For some reason, I'd probably fucking like it or something. If a girl held me hot, no, 72 hours, I'd freak out and definitely get an Uber. Oh, he didn't have his phone. Okay, yeah, I'd probably think I was going to die and call 911. Hold on. I know I saved a couple that I accidentally opened. Lainey Hughes. I hooked up with a rando in college, and after he started telling me that he actually already knew who I was, and that he knew my brother, and that he was a freshman on the football team when my brother was a senior, and he was going on about how much he looked up to my brother and admired how athletic he was, and it was just fucking weird and gross, so I ghosted him. I saw him at the bars a few weeks later, and he was trying to talk to me, and I was obviously trying to swerve him. Somehow he managed to corner me and started screaming at me, "You know me. You know me. Why are you acting like you don't know me?" And two dudes had to pull him away. His name was Liam. That's so true, though. When girls, like, avoid dudes, yo, guys can't stand that. I honestly think it's every guy. Because dudes are just different. I guess because a guy would never ignore a girl on purpose. Raymond Cadow. Went home with a girl in freshman year, and she was determined to put on Gladiator so her roommate wouldn't hear us. Nothing like hearing Russell Crowe fighting in the arena while hooking up. Super romantic. The most romantic girl in the world. I can't ever... I don't know how people do that, but they, like, hook up with music on. Dude, I'm so jealous, man. Like, I'd be into it for a little bit, but... Like, I can't be doing something with a girl and, like, listening. And then we're both, like, kind of singing Trey songs. Making love faces. Making love. Like, during it. Love faces. Maybe I would like it. Honestly, I've done that to this song. And it was so, so the cringiest thing I've ever done. In a car. Me and this girl's relationship was on the rocks. And we just listened to this song. That little fucking noise. Can you imagine? Like during it. Like you're like with the girl. And like looking in your eyes. And it's just this. Why, that's so stupid. I love you. Hey, I really love you too. Kiss me. But... this song though? Oh! I've been out in these streets and not alone. Okay, every podcast, why not to play a Trey Song song? Trey Song song. Even though she's in my own, this ain't where my heart belongs. The whole time that was going on in the car, I was like in the back of my head, I was like, does she just like this song? And then part of me, because I'm the most jealous man in the world, the part of me was like, or does she just like Trey Songs? And is she pretending I'm Trey Songs? No love in here. Soon as I get through. And then the other part of me was like, wait a minute. I'm pretending I'm Trey Songs. What if you could sing like this? Alright, okay, I'm in love with Trey Songs. Hey girl, I know sex ain't better than love. Okay. All right, so yeah, let's do days of the week. Now that you guys know literally everything about me, that is the weird thing about this podcast, though, is that I've not held anything back. But that's what you want, right? Days of the week. Here we go. What do we got, huh? Let's look at this draft I make in my emails every week with a bunch of stuff on it and never look at it. Oh, we haven't even gone viral. Oh, my God. Okay, let's do some viral. Hashtag, you ain't nothing like me. Hashtag, you ain't nothing like me. Hashtag, you ain't nothing like me. If you haven't accidentally kept your car running... Why you do something that when your car should definitely not have been running. Dude, I've left my car running in a parking spot for like 4 hours and I had no clue. I did a whole comedy show. Was I nervous? It was in LA. God, that's so damn dumb. Parked my car, did a whole entire show, and hung out with somebody after the show. Like, somebody went to the show, heard I was doing a show, went there. I got, like, a drink with them. So that's, like, an extra hour and a half. Like, had, like, a heart-to-heart. And then I came back, and I was like, why is my car on? So dumb. Is that a normal thing? I swear to God. And the whole time, I'm like, cars can do that? All right, hashtag, I can totally relate to that. Hashtag, I can totally relate to that. Hashtag, I can totally relate to that. Can anybody relate to this? One time I was looking for my AirPods for like 13 minutes, like kind of getting hot and freaking out, and they're in my ears. But like, and I was so happy when I realized they're in my ears. Like, overjoyed. I was like, oh, yes. Like, that's got to be, like, people in heaven had to be looking at me like, dude. Every time I do something dumb like that, I think about people that I, like, know who have passed away, like, just looking at me like, yo, you're the dumbest person ever. Like, oh, he's about to leave his car on. He's about to leave his car. He's about to leave his car on for 5 hours straight. Ah! All right, let's do days. Wednesday. National Teddy Bear Day. Dude, I had Beanie Babies. That was like my stuffed animal. My family was big into that. Low-key, I think like they still are. My sisters are still like, but you didn't have the Princess Diana one. I'm like, dude, we're 40. And I'm such a dumbass. I ripped all the tags off of mine. I do that with everything. Dude, if I can rip a tag off some jeans, I don't even know if I want the jeans yet. I'm still in the store and I'm like... I can't stand it. I ripped all the tags off my Beanie Babies, and then like 2 weeks later, they were worth like $400 a piece. Of course. Those were such a big deal. Thursday, National TV Dinners Day. I always wanted to have a TV dinner just so I could like eat it in the living room on the couch. I'd never cared about the TV dinner. I just wanted to eat dinner in the living room. And every time my family was like, no! Or we'd get TV dinners, and I'd be like, finally, and we'd have to eat them at the table. I'd be like, what's the point? National School Picture Day. The shiniest, wettest faces of all time. Class of 2020. Always make fun of like how weird your posture is. The photographer's like, okay, sit in the chair, and the chair's like facing the camera, and you're like, okay. And he's like, now turn your head all the way around. And you're like, are you sure you should? He's like, yep, that's it. Your head looks like the Exorcist movie when the girl's head spins all the way around. You're like, is this good? And he's like, cheese. Blood coming down your mouth. Okay. Friday, National Make Your Bed Day. Why is it such a big deal, making your bed? Honestly, I haven't made my bed ever since I left high school. I know it's like after I said that, a lot of people are like this. After I said that, honestly, I haven't made my bed since I left high school. This.
Aww.
I want a soundboard for this goddamn show so bad. One of these days, this podcast is going to be legit, and we're going to have soundboards and producers, and Ashley's going to be a real person. Yes. When I get a producer for this podcast, it's going to be the biggest bitch of all time. I'm going to start having tryouts. Who's the biggest bitch? Me. And I'm like, me. I'm like, me. And then some girl's just like, I don't care about this anymore. And I'm like, you. And then you guys are like, aww. Okay, I just saw something scary on the computer and kind of don't want to do this podcast anymore because it's literally 2 a.m. Okay. Yeah, I haven't made my bed, though. I just make my bed and then sleep under another blanket, so my bed's just always made. He's the laziest man. The laziest man. He's the laziest man in the world. Saturday. National Chocolate Milkshake Day. Just thinking about a chocolate milkshake, just reading that, I already have bad breath. If I drink a chocolate milkshake, my breath smells like a chocolate milkshake till Christmas. National Day of Encouragement. Okay, I'm not doing that. Sunday, National Peanut Day. Peanuts mess me up. I love them, but dude, if I eat too many peanuts, if I eat like a little more than like a handful of trail mix the rest of the day, I'm like, you got it. I don't know if I can make it. I don't know if I can't. National Bald is Beautiful Day. No, it's not. Man, I'm so glad I did that to my hair. Hair update. It's looking bad. But it looks like when you get a hair transplant like I did, it looks worse before it gets better. And I promise that's true because I talk to people. But yeah, you guys can see my head in like 4 months or something like that. National Grandparents Day. What a day. Did everybody's high school have Grandparents Day? Ours did. And literally, if it was 2 degrees hotter, what a trap. Let's put all the grandparents that are like, you know, kind of not in the best condition because they're really old. They can't really adjust to, you know, temperatures, things like that. If it gets too hot, you know, they might not be a good idea. Let's have them all over to our school, and we'll put them in the gym. And, yeah, we'll have church, and it'll be a great day. Oh, what's that? Oh, we don't have air conditioning? It's fine. How did not every grandparent just drop? That always scared the shit out of me. Grandparents' Day, I was like, well, sayonara, papa. See you on Christmas, hopefully. Pampa. All right. That's 123.
1, 2, 3. I love you.
Thanks for listening. Thanks for sending in your most annoying mispronunciations. I can't even say that. Thanks for sending in your most annoying mispronunciations. There it is. I'll come out with a different question next week. But remember to follow on Twitter, Instagram, Cameo, TikTok, all at Benedict Polizzi. Subscribe to the podcast, rate, review, and tell a homie. Because we got to make this fam even bigger. We got to have a fam pick that's so big, there's like more families in the pit. You know, there's like sub-families. You know when people have families that are so big that wear like different colored t-shirts?
I hate that.
But that's our fam. Soon. All right. I don't know how I feel about this podcast. I thought it was pretty fun. But what do you guys need for this podcast to be every week smacking? Do you need me to go crazy? Because I will. Just let me know. Okay. See ya. All right. I'll talk to you guys next week. Damn, that was aggressive. All right. I'll talk to you guys next week. I found. Man, I just shit to do on him.
shit with them.